So thanks for your help. Not that I couldn't have handled them on my own, mate. Of
course you could. I could see that. Just fancied a bit of exercise, that's all.
Aye. Captain Baines.
Captain Burgess.
Not often I play cards for money, but when I do, I play square. No one calls me a cheat and gets away with it.
Even if it costs you a broken arm?
All the same, you did a fine job patching me up. You did some pearling, you said.
Aye. There was this Dutchman. He had a small catch and no money, and as I had $200 at the time, we became partners. Of course, everybody on the waterfront called me a fool.
What, for taking a chance?
Well, there's a bit more to it than that. You see, old Van Meer was fond of the bottle, and when he was drunk, he'd tell stories of this lagoon he knew where you could pick up pearls the size of pigeons' eggs. He was on his B-man's, bit of a joke.
Aye, like the Caribbean. At least a couple of hundred people there know where to find Morgan's treasure, and they're jokers, the lot of them.
Well, this time it was no joke. 3 months later, we sailed back with $40,000 worth of pearls aboard.
$40,000?
Aye. Old boy wanted me to go back for a second bite, but I said no. Months later, he got hit by a hurricane. Went down in the very lagoon where we'd been pearling.
Well, here's to Lady Luck.
I reckon I've had my fair share.
I reckon you have, too. That's where you got the money to buy your own steamer.
Aye. She's small, not much to look at, but she's all mine.
What's she called?
Black Pearl.
Mr. Dawkins, you trying to ruin me?
Sir?
At the exchange, I quoted 24 shillings and 10 pence a ton. Now, here's my slip, right?
Yes.
Well, then how come that your clerk invoiced this cargo at 24 shillings and a penny?
Oh, surely not, sir.
Oh, surely, yes. Here it is, black and white. 9 pence a ton short. Now, you multiply that by 1,000 tons, and it comes to a lot of brass.
Yes, £37.10.
I know I can do arithmetic. The point is, are there any more mistakes like that?
Oh, I'm sure this is an isolated case.
Yes, well, I should hope so. You know, your predecessor, Mr. Tupman, used to check everything twice. And once again for luck.
Mr. Needham,
does it? Yes, come in.
James, have I caused an inconvenience?
No, Letty, come on in. The Dawkins here is just going.
You've upset him again.
Well, more like he's upset me. You know, he'll never be as good as old Tupman.
Well, not while you go on treating him like an errand boy, he won't.
Oh. I should have gone to Belfast with Will, you know.
Oh, James, you promised you'd have a spell ashore.
Well, I'm here, aren't I? Both feet on dry land.
Aye, and aging every minute of it.
No.
Oh, a couple of weeks at home and you're bored already. With the office, with that house. I sometimes wonder if you're bored with me.
Nay, Letty. No, I'm just a bit restless.
No, James. You're one of the biggest ship owners in Liverpool. Why can't you just relax and, well, enjoy the fruits of your success?
Look, if I was in steam, maybe I could. But I'm in sail. I've got to fight for every cargo. I can't do that behind this here desk.
Daniel. Still playing truant from Westminster?
I was told I'd find you here, Samuel.
Something wrong, Uncle?
Oh, no. Just wanted to have a word, that's all. I'm on my way to the station.
Yes?
To meet William.
Oh.
Has Charlotte mentioned anything?
About William?
Yes.
No.
I see. Well, I don't like betraying a confidence, Samuel, but I feel I have to for your sake.
Go on.
William wrote a letter to Charlotte, and your Aunt Elizabeth gave it to her. Now, of course, I have no idea what the letter said, but I do know that he wanted to see her.
When was this?
Just before the christening.
Oh, that was over 2 weeks ago.
Yes. But obviously, I would hate there to be trouble between you and William, and I shall make this known to him. Now, it was a noble gesture you made in marrying Charlotte.
Oh, hardly noble, Uncle. I happen to love Charlotte.
But all the same.
And I think I can keep my own house in order. But thank you for the information. Now, if you'll excuse me. Charlotte, I'd like an answer.
The letter was addressed to me, Samuel. It was personal.
Personal? Damn it, I'm your husband.
And you own me completely, is that what you mean?
No, I mean that this concerns us both.
No. What you really mean is that you don't trust me.
I certainly don't trust William. I'll not have him in this house. Now, may I see that letter, please?
No. I burnt it.
I see. Do you intend seeing him?
No.
Then there's no more to be said, is there?
Why didn't you tell me that he'd written to you?
Well, I suppose I didn't wish to raise that particular ghost again.
Prospecting for gold? William, I can hardly believe it.
I wasn't very good at it. But later, in Australia, at a place called Lightning Ridge, I made over £1,000 opal mining. And then a month after that, I lost every penny in one marvellous all-night poker game.
£1,000? Oh, William, how could you?
Well, my boy, you certainly seem to have lived life to the full.
Well, that's what it's there for, isn't it, Father?
I think so.
I was given the opportunity to explore the world, and in the process, myself. I'm grateful for that.
Well, the important thing is that you're home, safe and sound. And I give you fair warning, William, now that you are home, you're going to be my escort to every ball and soiree in the county, and I'm going to show you off quite unmercifully.
I see. Are you not to take part in this marathon, Father?
Oh, no, your father has far too much to occupy him in London. The affairs of state weigh heavily on him, William, and he sometimes works quite late into the night. Don't you, Daniel?
I think it's time we went up to dress.
Oh, dear, and I just decided to have another sherry. Would you mind, William?
No.
Don't let me delay you, Daniel.
How long has this been going on, Mama?
How long has what been going on?
You and Father at loggerheads. Is it about me?
No. Now, you mustn't concern yourself.
But I do.
We often quarrel, sometimes quite heatedly, you know that.
Yes, but now there seems to be only coldness between you. I'll see you at dinner, Mama.
You're supposed to be senior master of the Aeneiden line. Set an example to others. And what do you do? Break an arm in a barroom brawl.
It could have happened to anyone.
Well, it didn't, did it? It happened to you. Two more runs left before this contract's completed.
I know that.
Well, I'll best go myself.
Eh? Well, I brought the ship back home, didn't I? I mean, there's no need for you to go to Belfast.
No, my mind's made up. Besides, a spell ashore will do you good.
You sure you're only thinking of me?
Well, of course I am. Besides, I might pick up a bit of business in Belfast. You know, to sit behind that desk won't do you any harm.
Eh?
Well, somebody's got to look after the shop.
Well, what's wrong with your chief clerk? I mean, when you have Mr. Tupman.
Ah, Tupman. He was worth twice what this Dawkins is.
Well, I hate paperwork.
So do I, but it's got to be done.
Here. You're not expecting me to go on the floor of the exchange, are you?
Well, of course I am.
Among all them toffee-nosed owners?
We're not all toffee-nosed.
Oh, no?
No. Luke, you smarten yourself up. Put on your best bib and tucker. You could cut quite a figure in that exchange.
All the same, I reckon you're enjoying all this.
Luke, if you hadn't broken your arm, you wouldn't be in this position. Well, if I've got to turn that ship around, I'd best get a move on. Here you are. Make yourself at home. I'll see you when I get back. Here.
Thank you.
morning. Would you tell your mistress Mr. William Fraser has called to see her?
Sorry, sir. Mrs. Dunedin is not at home.
Of course she is. I saw her at the window just now.
Yes, sir. But begging your pardon, she's not at home to you, sir. Sorry, sir.
For a few days.
But there's three rooms yet to furnish. The men are coming tomorrow with the pattern books and the swatches. You promised you'd be here so we could choose them together. We talked about it only yesterday.
Look, you don't want me. I'm no good at that sort of thing. Here, why not ask Sarah?
She'll jump at the chance of spending my brass.
2 months ashore, you said. Get properly settled in the new house, you said. Your words, James.
Well, can I help it if he's fool enough to go and break his arm?
There are plenty of other masters on the beach, and you know it.
Aye, maybe, but look, I want to look over a couple of ships in Belfast. All this fuss just for a few days.
Oh, you'd fuss soon enough if I let you down.
What, all this about a bit of wallpaper?
It's not just that, James, and well, you know it.
Well, what is it, then?
Is it... It's just that I feel a bit lost without you these days, that's all. And if that annoys you, I'm sorry.
Hey. Hey.
Let's get your things packed.
Hmm. 19 shillings a ton doesn't seem very high, Mr. Dunwoody. Well, yes, I know the others are lowering their rates. Well, look, just get the best price you can.
You should know me way by now.
No, I don't think I'll be in the office today, Mr. Dunwoody. I'll see you tomorrow. Goodbye.
No peace and quiet for Dunwoody since you bought that thing.
Have you called to tell me how to run my business, James?
No, I haven't. But here, talking about business, you know that army contract I offered you? £500, I think
no,
you said.
No, it was you who said £500, James.
Ah, yes, well...
Anyway, I've handed the whole matter over to Mr. Dunwoody.
Well, I don't want to talk to him. Look, this is between you and me.
You'll find him at the exchange.
Look, I'm just off to Belfast.
What? When you promised Letty you'd remain ashore for 2 months?
How did you know?
She told me. Oh, now I suppose you've upset her again.
No! Well, she was a bit put out. Look, that's not what I've come to talk about.
No, I'm sure it's not. You're always thinking of yourself, you are, James.
What are you on about now?
Letty! Can't you see how unhappy she is?
Letty unhappy? Rubbish.
Oh, well, perhaps unhappy's not the right word, but she's dissatisfied, unfulfilled. She needs more in her life than that business.
She's got the house. Got me.
She needs a child, James.
No, she doesn't.
I know she says she doesn't.
No. We've spoken about it. I said at the time I wasn't going to put her through that again. Anyway, it's none of your business.
Yes, it is. James, I'm your sister.
Elizabeth, I don't want to...
You're both bottling up your true feelings for one another.
I don't want to talk about it. It's not the sort of thing you talk about, even between brother and sister.
I'm sorry, James. I'm just trying to help.
Hi. They say Dunwoody's at the exchange. Well, best go there then, isn't I? Hi. Time's cracking on. Here, give my regards to Daniel. Always assuming, of course, that you are still talking to one another.
I called at your house this morning, Samuel. My house is forbidden to you, William, as well you know.
Yes, yes, you made that quite clear in your letter.
Then don't attempt to force the issue.
I intend to see Charlotte and my son. You have no right to dictate...
You keep away from me and mine.
Samuel...
Because if you persist...
Will you please...
I shall damn well horsewhip you in public.
Ah,
Dunwoody. Just off to Belfast. A little matter I want to clear up with you before I go.
Oh, yes, sir.
Yes, it's this government contract I picked up, transporting army horses to the Sudan. I think my sister's had a word with you about it.
Yes, yes, she did mention it, sir.
Yes, well, we more or less agreed that £500 would be fair recompense for me trouble.
Oh, indeed, it would have been, sir.
What do you mean, would have been?
Well, if Khartoum hadn't fallen. But now that we're evacuating the Sudan, the need for horses will diminish rapidly. I'm afraid that cargo has very little value, sir.
Are you telling me now that you don't want it?
Oh, no, I'll take it off your hands, sir.
How much?
Well, you having no steamships of your own, sir, and you having signed a contract that specifies a steamship, well, to save you any embarrassment, shall we say £100?
No, we shall not say £100. You're getting too sharp by half, don't worry.
Uncle?
Oh, William. Oh, you back? Just off to Belfast, excuse me.
Well?
Well, what?
Urgent, your message said. Do you want me to wave you goodbye or something?
Your arm hurting or something?
No, why?
Because you're as sour as lemons, that's why.
Well, that's office work. I made a fast passage back from Belfast.
Oh, I'm not going to go through all that again, are we? Do you think I wouldn't rather be at home with Letty?
What's all this and so urgent, then?
Oh, yeah. You remember that contract I picked up in Egypt?
One that you were going to offer to your sister, you said?
Yes, yes. Well, I think we'd be better off with another line. You should have no trouble placing it.
In other words, the freezer line are not interested.
No, I mean you'll get a better price for it elsewhere. I was right. You are as sour as lemons.
Returning to the office this afternoon.
Why do you ask?
I thought you might care to go riding.
With you? I think not, Daniel.
Oh, damn it, Elizabeth, just how long is this going on?
Until either it no longer hurts or until it no longer matters.
Elizabeth, if you want me to put on sackcloth and ashes and walk through the streets of Liverpool, I'll do it.
I don't wish you to do anything, except perhaps return to London.
I'll return to Westminster only when we've settled this matter. And I'll go on telling you that Angela Taplow means nothing to me until at last you believe it.
I think perhaps I'll finish these at the office.
Hello, who is that? Oh, good Lord, what are you doing in Liverpool?
Mary, lay out my riding habit, please, and tell the groom to saddle up both my horse and Sir Daniel's.
Angela, you know perfectly well why you shouldn't telephone me. I am trying to save my marriage. For heaven's sake, Angela, yes, of course I'll see you when I return to London, but please try to understand it's very difficult to talk at the moment.
The log again, Mr. Beale.
Captain Bates was right. We did make good time last trip.
Aye, we did. But then we had a soldier's win.
Hmm. Well, soldier's win or no, we'll have to do better.
That won't be easy, sir.
Well, if we don't, you'll never let me hear the last of it.
Press on more canvas, Mr. Beale. Best of this wind while we've got it.
Aye, aye, sir.
It's not right, Fletcher. They don't allow women on the floor of the Baltic Exchange, so I don't see why we should have them up here.
Nothing against it in the rules, old boy.
Of course there isn't. Who ever heard of a woman running a shipping line before?
You try getting the committee to make a new rule, Benson, you'll meet with opposition. Me, for one.
Never could resist a pretty face, could you, Fletcher?
Yes. I wasn't expecting you on the floor today, my lady.
No. I've just come from the office. I was wondering if perhaps my son...
Oh, Mr. Fraser was here this morning, m'lady, together with Mr. Samuel O'Needing.
Together?
Oh, they arrived separately. They merely met here.
And departed separately?
Yes.
I'm thinking of going away.
Oh?
Yes, for a short holiday. Oh, but of course that would mean leaving you to run the shipping lines and yard all on your own.
I'm sure I can cope, Lady Fogarty.
Yes, I'm sure you can. It's a relief to have someone I can rely on.
I do my best.
And I'm very grateful that you do. We must talk about your position and salary in the company. Yes, well, we'll talk soon, Mr. Dunwoody.
That's no good, Sarah. I just can't decide. Well, if you want my opinion, this goes with that. And then in the small bedroom, you want this paper here with the curtains made up from this velvet here. Perhaps you're right. Oh, on the other hand...
On the other hand, why don't I come back tomorrow and we can make up our minds then?
Oh, that would be asking too much of you, Sarah.
Oh, nonsense. I love getting out of the house. You know I do. I do so infrequently these days. I hardly see anything of Samuel. And I haven't seen Anne or Robert since the christening.
No, Samuel and Charlotte do keep very much to themselves, don't they?
Well, they do have their own lives to lead.
All the same. I'd like to see more of the children.
Yes. Talking of children, have you and James thought any more
about... No.
But Letty, it's 2 years now since you lost the baby.
Sarah, I said at the time that I wanted no more children. I meant it then and I mean it now.
It's just that I always knew that James always wanted a son.
James and I both agreed on this point, Sarah.
But how on earth can you manage to... Oh. I've touched on a delicate nerve. I'm sorry.
Children all tucked up?
Yes. That makes 14.
Sorry?
I've been counting. Every evening when I come down from the nursery, you ask the self-same question.
Because I'm naturally interested.
Well, that wasn't the point I was trying to make. Oh, it doesn't matter.
I understand William called this morning.
Yes. And I refused to see him.
So he told me.
You've spoken to him.
This morning. He'll not trouble you anymore.
You underestimate William.
Oh, no, I don't think so. Not after the warning I gave him. He won't come calling again.
Oh, no?
No.
Well, Samuel, for your information, William spent most of this afternoon waiting on the pavement outside. And he called at the door at least 5 times. That's what he thinks of your warning.
William?
No. Thank you. Thank you. Well, my boy, have you found much that has changed in the 2 years you've been away?
People, mainly.
Yes.
Some more than others.
And your first day home, has it been busy?
Considering I spent most of it outside Samuel's house trying to see Charlotte and Robert, no.
Well, you could hardly expect to be welcomed with open arms.
No, just a degree of understanding, that's all.
William, you're expecting too much.
What? To see my own son and have a few words with Charlotte? I don't call that unreasonable.
Well, I do. You must surely admit that in not marrying her, you acted dishonorably.
No, I don't deny
and
that.
And that all credit must go to Samuel for marrying Charlotte and bringing the child up as his own.
Yes, I do accept
then
that.
Then surely the only honourable thing to do is to keep out of their lives. Now, damn it, I know you won't find
How
it easy.
How dare you sit there smugly talking about honour? You'd do well to look to your own life before you start preaching to your son.
Elizabeth?
Are you so blind you can't see the boy is simply following your pattern of behaviour?
Nothing of the kind.
Oh, isn't it? You got me with child and then ran off to Australia, leaving me to marry Albert Fraser. And when you did return, 17 years later, not only did you insist on seeing William, but on telling him who you were. It's history repeating itself. Only in your case, it was all very honourable, wasn't it?
Yes, because you seem to have conveniently forgotten that when I returned, Albert was dead. Now, Samuel is very much alive and he's made his wishes quite plain. Now, all I'm saying is that William should respect those wishes.
And have either of you given a thought to how Charlotte might feel? No, of course not. She is, after all, only the mother of the child, just a woman.
If you'll excuse me, I think I'll go to bed. Quite frankly, I don't think either of you are in a position to advise anyone.
Returning a compliment. Saw you dock, Captain Baines. Brought you your breakfast. Oh, sorry, I expected to find Captain Baines here.
So I got it. Friend of his?
Acquaintance. I'm Captain Burgess.
Ah, Seth Burgess. Useful with his fists, by all accounts.
You must be James O'Needham.
Baines is having a spell ashore.
Oh, I see. Well, sorry to have disturbed you.
That bottle going begging?
Yes. Yes, of course.
Good. Cook makes rotten coffee. I hear you own a steamer.
Aye.
How big?
300 tons.
Oh, quite small.
Next one will be bigger.
Oh, got plans, have you?
Haven't you, Captain O'Needham?
Glasses are behind you.
One day, I'll have as many ships as you, sir. Only they'll all be steamers.
Well, I hope you can afford to feed them. They're greedy brutes when it comes to coal.
They've got an appetite, I'll grant you that.
So, how long have you been in Belfast?
3 weeks.
3 weeks, eh? Engine repaired?
New stern tubes, some engine work.
3 weeks. Oh, that'll cost you a tidy bit of brass. Maybe take a walk along there later on.
Me a couple of minutes with him before you come over.
You won't fool him, you know, Captain Baines. Mr. O'Needham's already tried.
I know all about that. You just do as I told you.
Captain Baines, don't tell me you've deserted the sea in favor of commerce.
Well, the decision was more or less made for me, Mr. Dunwoody. Only be for a while, and during that time I looked to you for advice. See that I don't make too many mistakes.
Well, I shall be pleased to assist if I can. You know how the exchange works, of course.
Aye. Well, roughly. Pity is, I only wish you needn't line out a few steamships right now.
That doesn't sound like you, Captain Baines.
Well, I... See, I don't like to give business away, Mr. Dunwoody. You see, Mr. O'Needham has this army contract. Horses to the Sudan. Now, he offered it to some ship owner, I don't know who. Luckily, he turned it down.
How do you mean, luckily?
Well, one of our ships had just arrived back from Egypt, you see. Now, the master tells me that since they decided to evacuate the Sudan, they're crying out for steamships to bring the stuff back home. So that's horses out, general cargo home. Now, that's what I call good business. The pity is, we can't handle it. It's steamer trade. Well, Mr. Dawkins?
750 from one, 800 from the other. Seems they both want that contract.
Well, of course they do. But I'm not going to auction the damn thing. First one to come to 1,000, says yes to it, he can have it. You tell him that.
Right.
I'll take that contract off your hands for 900, Captain Baines.
You, Mr. Dunwoody?
Provided you'll agree here and now.
Oh, well, seeing it's you.
Yes.
Well, I'll send a clerk over to your office later on.
That's one up to me and one in the eye for Mr. O'Dean.
You're right. She has got good lines for a steamer. Hmm. Only one thing spoils her looks.
And what's that?
The note is nailed to your mast. Your ship's been impounded.
What the? That damn scab Campbell. He did it after all.
If I could lay my hands on him right now.
Right now, you need to lay your hands on some money. Let's take a walk back to my ship, eh? How much, then?
What?
How much do you owe?
500. Well, nearer six.
Well, it was only 3 weeks. This Campbell's a bit quick off the mark, demanding his money back, isn't he?
I said the repairs took 3 weeks.
Well, how long's it been, then?
3 months.
Heck. Have you paid him out?
No. I'll find somewhere. I've got this contract promised.
Well, that's no good without a ship. Look, supposing I was to buy a few shares in the Black Pearl, eh?
How many?
51.
What? Give you control?
All right, split it down the middle, 50-50 each. But I'm to be named managing owner.
Oh, no, I think not.
If you sailed under the Uneaton flag, you could take half the profits.
Aye, and you'd pick up the other half. No, thank you, Uneaton. I'll find a way.
Oh, well, please yourself. I sail at first light.
Then I wish you a good voyage home.
Something's troubling you, Elizabeth. Is it to do with William?
No.
Business?
Daniel.
Well, what?
He has a mistress, Letty.
Believe Elizabeth, are you sure?
Yes.
No, I mean, really sure. Does Daniel admit to this?
Oh, I don't care what Daniel says, not anymore. Letty, I know.
What on earth will you do?
Well, my first thought was divorce.
Oh, Elizabeth, surely it hasn't come to that. You'd be a social outcast. It would ruin Daniel's career.
I know. It's just that in my heart, I know we can no longer live together as man and wife.
My way.
After 2 years, surely you can spare me a few minutes.
No.
Charlotte, there's something very important I have to say concerning you and the child. But first, may I please see my son?
Your son? You have the gall to call him your son? The child you abandoned? I tell you, William Fraser, I only have contempt for you. You left me to fend for myself because you hadn't the backbone to face up to your responsibilities. I despised you then, and I despise you now.
Don't light the lamps, William. Come and sit by the fire. You're cold.
Yes. It's been a
a long time since we sat like this. Very long time.
Do you want to talk?
In a moment.
Get some breakfast inside us, Patrick. Then it's back to the stokehold.
Morning to you, Burgess.
Morning, Eden. Told you'd find a way.
How'd you get her out of Belfast?
Walked her out in dead of night.
What, just the two of you?
No, eight of us. Patrick comes from a large family. We've been stoking since dawn. Another hour, we'll have steam up.
I doubt if you've got the time. Looks like you're Mr. Campbell now, coming to collect his money. Think he'll like this at all?
No. And Eden, you've got to help me. Take us in tow.
Oh, let my ship impounded as well?
Damn it, man, they could throw me in jail. I could lose the ship for good.
Yes, you could. Of course, if we was partners, like I suggested, I could pay all your debts. In fact, I'm prepared to make out a banker's draft the moment that he sets foot on board.
And you'd end up controlling my ship? No, thank you, Eden.
Very well, then. Well, looks like you've got about 10 minutes to enjoy your ownership.
Listen, if I could keep control...
Mr. Beale! Prepare to make ready! I'm coming across!
Half shares, but me as managing owner. How about that?
You know my terms.
You know damn well I've got my back to the wall.
Well, whose fault's that? Hey, you put yourself there. Well, is it a deal?
Only if you pay for the repairs.
I'll pay for the Belfast repairs.
Then we have a deal, partner.
Then I'll stay on board, partner.
Only last night we sat here and talked.
Yes.
He bought a villa. A villa overlooking the Mediterranean. Said he wanted to live there, just for a year. He.
Elizabeth, let go. I let the tears come.
No. It isn't real. And we must discuss our future.
Oh, that can wait.
Yes, Daniel, now. I want to talk about us.
No, it's not the time. And what can I say? That I still love you? That you need me?
No. That's the sadness, Daniel. I've lived too long on my own. I don't need you.
Elizabeth, I do love you.
I only wish I could forgive and forget.
But you can't.
No.
Can I? They say that but for William's bravery, several of those children would certainly have been killed.
William. Dead.
Oh, try not to upset yourself, dearest.
It was only yesterday. All he wanted was to see his son. Used him. It was such a little thing to ask.
You weren't to know this was going to happen.
I could have let him see his son. You could have. We could have had more compassion. Now it's too late.
She'd better go and lie down.
Newspapers say he died a hero.
Yes.
Daniel, time like this, not much one can say.
He'd only come home for a month. Plan to settle up his affairs and then go back to France. I didn't know that. He told Elizabeth only the night before.
Talking of Elizabeth, she's going to need you now.
No.
Of course she will.
Now, James, you don't understand.
I think I do. Elizabeth and Letty are quite close.
Oh.
Anyway, that's all in the past. Right now, she needs you.
No, James. Now, last night we talked for the first time in weeks. I offered to stay, but Elizabeth said no. It's almost as though William was the one bond that held us together. Though I find that hard to believe. Anyway, it's all settled. I leave for London today.
Hang on. Stay and fight.
No, it's not really something you can fight for. Can't demand love, not from Elizabeth.
Well, it's your life.
She won't lie down.
She says she wants to be with Daniel. Hello.
Well, best go then.
But James.
No. They need to be alone.
How long before your train?
2 hours.
Walk with me, Daniel. In the garden.